Hello everyone again, welcome back to our online class. So this is Friday, right? And every Friday we always learn about speaking tutor 1B, right? So this is the book that we always learn on every Friday in our level 7B. And I hope you have this book all together. So last week we finished lesson 1, right? And today we are going to our lesson 2. So if you have the book, you can open the book on page 18. On page 18 here, you will see the grammar point, the grammar focus that we are going to focus about will and going to, right? So I'm sure you have learned a lot about will and going to in the lower levels, okay, or in the past. But now today we are going to study about will and going to again because they are important and we should know. And I'm sure that you know that will and going to, we use them to talk about the future plans, right? But sometimes they are very confusing, whether we don't know whether I want to use will or want to use going to, because there are some rules, some circumstances that you have to use will, sometimes you have to use going to, but sometimes we can use both, will and going to at the same time. So that's why these grammar points are very confusing, right? The word confusing that we learned. Okay, so now let's go to the grammar focus that you can also see on your book on page 18. So we are talking about will and going to. So we use will with immediate decision. So when you make a decision in a very quick way, you have to use will. For example, now it's raining. And then you say, I will not go home. Okay, so you say, I will not go home. Why you say, I will not go home? Because it is raining, right? You didn't plan that you will not go home at this time, but you just say, I will not go home after you see the rain is falling, right? So that's why we say, we use will with immediate decision, okay? So here with it, decision. Decision is a noun, right? And the verb is decide, right? So verb decide, the noun is decision. Immediate decision refer to a decision that you make very quickly, right? Okay, so the first one will be used with the immediate decision. The second one is unclear prediction. Prediction means guess or estimation. So unclear prediction. So for example, you say, I will be an outstanding student next year. So you say you will be an outstanding student next year. It's just your prediction. You don't know whether it's going to happen or not. Unclear, right? That's why we use will. I will be an outstanding student. You don't know whether you can be an outstanding student or not. Okay, that's why we say will. We use with immediate decision and also the unclear prediction. Okay, so now let's go to going to. So going to, we use going to talk about the future plans that are, I mean, we refer to the scheduled events, the events that are already scheduled. For example, tomorrow I am going to the movie theater. So you know that tomorrow there is a movie, for example, at 6 p.m. and then you schedule your plan that you will go there. So I am going to watch a movie with my friends at 6 p.m., for example, okay? But the bad news is sometimes will and going to we can use in the same situation. For example, tomorrow I will be home at 5 p.m. Okay, and then you also can say tomorrow I am going to be home at 5 p.m. So we talk about the certainty about future actions. You know that tomorrow you will be home at 5 p.m. or you are going to be home at 5 p.m. So it is about certainty about future action if you know that that is really going to happen. So these are the usage of will and going to. They are a little bit confusing, but I'm sure that you can get something from this lesson. Okay, so after learning about will and going to, we have to do some exercises. So as you have the book, please open the book on page 19. So when you open the book on page 19, you will see what will you be doing, okay? So there are there is only one exercise. So what you need to do is you have to look at the two schedules of A and B, right? There are two schedules from Sunday to Monday. A schedule for next week and B schedule for next week. So you see what do they do on Sundays, Monday until Saturday, right? And then you have to read the conversation and you have to complete, okay? They are going to happen in the future. So you have to use future plans, will and going to, right? So this is your exercise on page 19, okay? You have to do it. And then you have to go to page 20. Page 20 is also your exercise. It is about what will you do with all of them. So you see four pictures, right? And you, and our exercise has number one to number four, like 1, 2, 3, 4. And what you need to do, you just look at the words that you are given in the brackets and then try to create questions with the future plans. For example, number one, they give you the word what and the word paint. So you say, what will you do with all of that paint? And then the Mr. B, we have the word paint and beautiful picture. You say, I'll paint a beautiful picture, right? So you write, you have to write what you are given. Example A again, where and put it. So what is your answer? Where will you put it? Okay. And the answer, I will hang it on the wall. Okay. So this is the example in number one. So you have to do number 2, 3, and 4, right? Okay. So your exercise is on page 19. And on page 20, right? I hope you do it, and you have to send it to your teacher so that the teacher can correct it. Okay, so that's the end of our lesson 2. Now let's go to our lesson 3. So our lesson 3, if you have the book, you can open the book on page 22. Lesson 3, December. Okay, lesson 3. So you can look at some vocabularies on the board, as you can see here. So there are the word postcard, stamp, bead, driftwood, candle, volleyball, jewelry, picture frame, and necklace. You know postcard, right? Postcard refers to a card that we have pictures on it. Okay, next is stamp. So stamp, so when you buy something from the supermarket, you will see the stamp on what you buy so that you can know how much it is cost. What is the price? We call stamp. And then bead. So as you can see in the picture, we use bead to decorate our jewelry, right? So it looks more beautiful. And then driftwood refer to the wood that floats, you know, float, right? Float on the water. So driftwood refer to the wood that float on the water. Mostly it is in the sea. Okay, so when it floats on the water, it comes to the beach. And then candle, you know, if you were born in countryside, I'm sure you know candle, right? So when there is no electricity at night, we always use the candle so that we can see each other, right? When there is no light, there is no electricity, we use candle. Okay, mostly the candle are mostly red and yellow, right? Okay, volleyball here is an adjective. It refers to something that worth a lot of money. Example, you say you are a valuable person. It means that you has a lot of value. Okay, so valuable. And jewelry like earrings, like watch, like necklace, we call jewelry. And then picture frame is the frame of the picture, right? And then necklace. Okay, so now what you need to do is you have to look at these words and then you have to use them to complete in the 6 sentences here. Okay, so now let's go to number 1. My grandpa has some old stamps in his stamps album that are what is your answer? Worry. So you have to find the adjective here, right? That are worry. So where is the adjective? Adjective is valuable, right? That are worry, valuable. Let's go to number 2. When you put a photo in a blah blah blah, it looks nice. So a photo in a picture frame, right? Okay, so frame of the picture. Okay, now let's go to number 3. Blah 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 is something you wear. So what do you wear? You wear what? You wear necklace, right? On our neck. Let's go to number 4. Wood that floats in the ocean and lands on a beach is called, what? Like I told you, it's called driftwood, right? Okay, so like I told you, driftwood refers to wood that floats on the water or in the ocean. You know ocean, right? Here it ocean. So ocean is a very big sea, right? Okay, ocean. And let's go to number 5. We can use blah 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 to make different kinds of jewelry. So we can use what? We can use bead, right? Bead. Let's go to number 6. My parents like to turn off all the lights and use blah 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 during special dinners. So we eat dinners in the evening or at night, right? So turn off all the lights and use what? Use candle, right? Very romantic. Okay, so now before moving on to the next exercise, now let's read our first exercise again. So number 1, my grandpa has some old stamps in his stamps album that are very valuable. Number 2, when you put a photo in a picture frame, it looks nice. It looks nice. Why look save it as? Because subject it, right? It is a third person singular, so we have to use we have to add as to the verb look. So it became it looks nice. Don't forget CE here, CE, nice, nice. So the S sound, nice. Like the word practice, practice, P-R-A-C-T-I-C-E, right? Practice, practice. And also the word performance, P-E-R-F-O-R-M-A-N-C-E, right? Performance. So when you see C-E, don't forget the sound. Okay, let's go to number three. A necklace is something you wear. So here CE again, a necklace, a necklace, a necklace is something you wear. Number four, wood that floats in the ocean and lands on a beach is called driftwood. Number five, we can use bead to make different kinds of jewelry. Number six, my parents like to turn off all the lights and use candle during special dinners. Okay, so this is our first exercise. Now let's go to our second exercise. So our second exercise, you can see on page 23, expression. So you are given the word I'll. I'll here is the contraction or the short form of I will, right? Will, going to do. Will, it means it is the contraction of we will, right? And going to visit. Okay, so here it is a conversation between Jay, you know, Jay is Jeremy and E is Emily, right? So I just write in short as Jay, Jeremy, E, Emily. So this is the conversation between these two people and you have to read it and you have to use this word to complete in the blank. So now let's go. Number one, the first speech. What are you, blah, 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 December? So what is your answer? What are you, what? What are you here, right? What are you going to do this summer? Okay, so what are you going to do this summer? You know summer, right? Summer is a hot season. So we have summer, winter, fall, spring, autumn. Okay, but in Cambodia, we have only two seasons, right? We have a dry season and rainy season. Okay, let's go to, so now Emily, I'm blah, blah, blah. My aunt in California. She lives on the beach. So I'm what? And what? I'm going to visit, right? So I'm going to visit my aunt in California. She lives on the beach. She lives with S, right? Why? Because the subject is she and she is singular, third person singular. So we have to add S to the verb, right? So she lives on the beach. You have to remember it. If you don't add S, she lives on the beach, it will be wrong. So you have to write, it will be grammatically wrong. So you have to add S. She lives on the beach. Here we did California. California. You know California? California is one of the states of the United States of America. So in America, there are how many states? There are 50 states, right? That's why the stars on the American flag are 50. So one star represents one state. So there are 50 states in America, like California, like New York, like Washington. Washington is the capital of America. So we have California, New York, Washington, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, District of Columbia, Ohio, Texas. There are a lot more, right? I have never been there, but I just, you know, watch the news and I know about the states in America. Okay, so now let's continue. Awesome. 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 Awesome here means fantastic, cool, great, wonderful. Will you serve while you are there? I'll serve and blah, 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 collect driftwood with my aunt. I'll serve and what is it? Here, right? And I'll collect driftwood with my aunt. So I'll serve and I'll collect driftwood with my aunt. And then Jeremy asked, driftwood? Why are you going to collect that? My aunt and I will make cool stuff out of it. So here you see my aunt and I. So normally when you want to mention a person and you have to mention that person first. For example, my aunt and I, you cannot write I and my aunt. In spoken language, I mean when you speak, probably you can say it, but when you write, you have to mention that person first before you. So for example, my aunt and I, my friend and I, my teacher and I, my sister and I. If you write I am my sister, it is not wrong, but normally you put I at the end, you and I, my mom and I, my dad and I. So you put an I first, but in spoken language, when you speak, it is no problem, okay? So my aunt, don't forget T here, my aunt and I will make cool stuff out of it. What kinds of things, blah, 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 you make? So what kind of things will, right? So what kinds of things will you make? Blah, blah, blah. Make things like picture frames, vases, and necklaces. See this? It has a driftwood beads. So what is the answer here? Will, right? So like I tell you, will here means it is the contraction of we will, right? We'll make things like picture frames, vases, and necklaces. See this? It has a driftwood beads. And next, that is neat. Will you make a necklace for my mom? I would love to, okay. Okay, so now that's in our expression, our second exercise. Now let's read again. Can you read it? Okay, very good. What are you going to do this summer? What are you going to do this summer? But when you speak fast, what are you gonna do? Gonna do, right? What are you gonna do? So go into, it becomes gonna. What are you gonna do this summer? I'm gonna visit my aunt in California. She lives on the beach. Awesome. Will you surf while you are there? I'll surf and I'll collect driftwood with my aunt. Driftwood? Why are you going to collect that? My aunt and I will make cool stuff out of it. What kinds of things will you make? We'll make things like picture frames, vases, and necklaces. See this? It has driftwood beads. That is neat. Will you make a necklace for my mom? I would love to. Okay, so now that's the end of our exercise 1 and now and exercise 2. So before we end our video, I would like to give you some homework. So please open your book on page 24 and 25. So these two are your homework, right? And they are so easy. Exercise on page 25, they are similar to the exercise that we did last week. So they will give you the answers and you just try to create the questions with why, what, how, will. So they are easy, right? So your homework is on page 24 and 25. I hope you do it and give it to your teacher and your teacher will correct for you. And today is Friday, right? And tomorrow we don't study, right? On Saturday and Sunday we don't study. How about on Monday? On Monday we don't study too, right? Why? On Monday we will not going to study. Why? Because what? Because what? Because what? Because on Monday is a holiday, right? So I hope to see you again on Tuesday. So what are we going to learn on Tuesday? Blueprint 2, right? Okay, so don't forget to prepare your textbook and see you again on Tuesday. Goodbye.